have the option to opt in if you purchase your vehicle before January, or from January 2012 on, you have the option of opting in to the new tax instead of continuing with the car tax.
Which goes back to making the test, the expectation of moving the vehicle.
There's information there, and some of the clarifications that were made in House Bill 80, the new changes in that. New and used vehicles are valued at retail price or value listed in the Department of Revenue's assessment manual, whichever is greater. Trade-ins, rebates, and cash discounts get deducted from that tax bill amount when you purchase for the vehicle. Tax commissioner has a shorter time frame to return that to the state. The dealer has a longer time to remit it to the tax commission. So it extends the dealer's time, but it shortens the tax commissioner's time.
Well, it's going to create a lot of heartache for tax commissioners.
I think
dealers too.
I'm not sure they're
in favor of a lot of this. Here's your catch on that first one where it says sale price or DOR assessment value. So if you go into a car lot and the dealer says you want $10,000 and you go to pay your tax on it and they say, well, I paid 10, and the state says, well, it's only worth 8, now you're mad at 2.
Yeah, but you're on the same scenario with somebody, you know, grandma's got this car and she sells it to somebody because she no longer uses it, and $5,000, for example, and then you go up there and you get by tag and it's a $10,000 vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
And somebody, you know, I mean, a lot of folks in those situations have already kind of made their financial arrangements for that kind of monetary impact at the purchase.
Right.
And then you move forward and get ready to get your tag, and all of a sudden, boom, here you're going to get with the right deal. It's going to be a struggle for somebody.
That's what I'm saying. It's going to throw a lot of people off.
They would not have changed it if it was going to be revenue neutral.
I agree with you.
There's a 1% title ad valorem tax on classic vehicles. 1963 and 1985, those were optional to have titles, and now we have 30%. If you appeal the value, you still have to pay 100% while it's under appeal. The exemption on energy use and manufacturing, this is phased in over a 4-year period, and it was for competitive purposes. A lot of the surrounding states were exempting that, and so to try to get some more industry into Georgia, they made that exemption. On the local level, you have an option of putting in an excise tax to offset what you've lost from the sales tax. The other thing about that too is, it's very hard to measure that, but the other thing is, because it's not a sales tax, that goes directly into the general fund instead of into this loss first.
Question is going to be, what do you want to exercise this option? I'm expecting to see whether you're in the same position as where you're in the
suite. Okay, any questions on those?